I lost my husband, and when I lost my husband, it was like a dog's facing me. I was out of work because I took care of him, and then eventually my money started decreasing, and so I had nowhere else to go.
Wendy's story is much like the dozens of others who are here getting a warm bed, three meals a day, and help with finding a permanent home, a job, and other services. This is Sarah's Hope Family Shelter in West Baltimore. It's located on Mount Street, just steps from the Western District Police Station. Wendy arrived here more than 3 months ago, and if plans go the way they're expecting to, she'll be in a permanent apartment with her two sons very soon.
And I was so humbled to come here because I didn't have any way to go. I really didn't.
Homelessness in Baltimore is a crisis right now. Housing is limited. Affordable housing is limited. Therefore, clients often have lengthy stays in homelessness until they can identify housing.
Penny Gibson is the program director here at Sarah's Hope Shelter.
The shelter is located in Sandtown, Winchester area of Baltimore City, which is one of the most impoverished areas of Baltimore City. We are a 150-bed shelter servicing female-headed households, male-headed households, and two-parent families. Our families who are employed, many of them are employed with low-paying jobs or minimum-wage jobs. Therefore, they can't afford rent and a BGE bill and a water bill.
This shelter is run by St. Vincent de Paul of Baltimore. John Chavone is the president and CEO.
For families that are living in poverty, the biggest cost is housing typically, and many spend in excess of 50% of their income to maintain their housing.
St. Vincent de Paul recently received a very large gift of a grant from the Amazon guy, Jeff Bezos. The Bezos Day One Families Fund Grant, which works with nonprofits that help homeless families, awarded a $5 million grant to St. Vincent de Paul. Chavone calls the gift transformative.
Their philosophy is, here's the money. You guys know best how to deploy this. So be creative. You can be flexible with the funds and deploy them in a way that really will move the dial to end homelessness in Baltimore.
More resources are always needed. More shelter resources are all. This shelter is always full. The other shelters in Baltimore City are full often. So more resources are always needed to service this population.
Sarah's Hope Program Director Penny Gibson. The grant money will be spread out among a number of programs that John Chavone says are focused on better coordination of services for the homeless.
We're going to bring up some new services that actually prevent families that are able to avoid shelter from going into the shelter system. And that's short-term financial assistance, intensive case management, finding alternative placements for them.
And back to Wendy and her two sons who have been staying here at the shelter for about 90 days. She says she will be getting help to pay the rent in her new place, thanks to the work of St. Vincent de Paul.
Well, since we came here, it's been nothing but a good experience, though. It's been a wonderful experience. The staff is wonderful. They treat us all with respect. We treat them with respect.
And while she admits the work can be heartbreaking, Sarah's Hope Family Shelter Program Director Penny Gibson likes to focus on the positive outcomes, like Wendy's journey.
On the flip side, when someone comes in after they've signed their lease and dangle their keys in the air, it's amazing, and that makes it all.